My dear students, today I am going to take an interesting topic, fruits. We all like fruits because the fruits is very tasty and contain many more nutrients for our health, and this will increase the immunity of our body. Fruits, what is a fruit? When the ovary develops into a structure, fleshy structure after fertilization, that is the fruit. Fruit is a ripened ovary after fertilization. After the fertilization, ovary enlarges and forms a fleshy part of the gland, that is the fruit. The edible fruits are fleshy in nature with a pleasant aroma and flavors. The fruits contain many nutrients like potassium, dietary fiber, folic acid, and vitamins. So many more important nutrient substances are there in fruits. The fruit yielding plants grow depending on the climatic region. In the colder region, some of the fruit yielding plants will grow. In the hot climates, some of the fruit yielding plants will grow. So depending upon the climatic region, the fruits are divided into two types. There are two types of fruit: temperate fruits and tropical fruits. Temperate fruits, the fruit yielding plants which grow in the cold countries like America, like that. For example, apple, pears, plums, etc. They are all cold climate fruits. They grow only the such a plant, the fruit yielding, apple yielding plants, pears, fruit yielding plants, and plums eating, producing plants will grow in the cold countries. So, temperate fruits. They are tropical fruits. Some of the fruit yielding plants will grow in the hot climate, like our country, India. It's a hot climate country, tropical country. So the plants which yield fruits grow in the hot climate regions, they are called tropical fruit yielding plants. For example, mango, jack, banana, they are the tropical plant which produce fruits, tropical fruits. The tropical fruit yielding plants will not grow in the temperate areas. The temperate fruit yielding plants will not grow in the tropical areas. So, particular climate is necessary for growing a particular type of fruit yielding plant. First, we'll take up the mango fruit. The mango fruit is the national fruit of India, our fruit, our native fruit. Botanical name is Mangifera indica, belongs to the family Anacardiaceae. Origin and area of cultivation. The mango fruit is native to southern India, southern Asia, especially Burma and eastern India. It is native to southern Asia. Major mango fruit producing states: Andhra Pradesh, Bihar, Gujarat, and Karnataka. Major mango producing districts are Tamil Nadu, Salem, Krishnagiri, and Tharmapuri. These three districts in our Tamil Nadu, plenty of mango plants are growing. Major cultivars, the main mango varieties, superior quality mango plants: Alfonso, Panganapalli, Neelam, Malgova, etc. So these four fruits, mango fruits, are very tasty, larger in size. They are considered as a superior quality. Come to the uses. The mango fruit, rich in beta-carotene. Beta-carotene is very much essential for vision. That will increase the vision in children. So it is a very important fruit for vitamin E. It is utilized as a dessert, canned fruit, dried and preserved fruits. Dessert means the food made up of fruits. Any fruit, when it is made up of fruits, that is considered as a dessert. Canned fruit, dried fruits, and preserved fruits, they can be utilized in many ways. Unripe mangoes used in chutneys, pickles, side dishes, or in some cases that is eaten raw with salt and chilies. So this is a very favorite item in South Indian, that is raw mangoes with salt and chilies. Mango pulp, that is used for the preparation of jelly. Then mango juice is also used for the preparation of soft drink prepared from the mango juice. Mango juice is a very familiar one, very famous. Come to the nuts. Nuts, it is a simple dry fruits composed of hard shell and an edible kernel, inside which an edible kernel is there. It belongs to dry indigenous fruit, and that is the simple dry fruits, considered as the simple dry fruits composed of hard shell. Outer shell is very hard and woody in nature. Here only the outer part of the shell of the fruit is very hard and woody in nature, and inside which there is an edible kernel is seen. Then it contains fats, fiber, protein, vitamins, minerals, and antioxidants. These are all many more good items, good nutritious substances are there in the nut, cashew nut. Tonight we'll see the cashew nut. Botanical name is Anacardium accidentale, family Anacardiaceae. Origin and area of cultivation: originated in Brazil and introduced in India. Major states which cultivate cashew nut: Kerala, Karnataka, Goa, Orissa, Maharashtra, and Tamil Nadu. What are the uses of cashew nut? The cashew nut is used for garnishing sweets and curries. That means, in order to decorate the sweets and curries, it is used. The paste prepared from the cashew nut used as a base of sauces for curries and some sweets. The roasted cashew nut and raw kernels are used as snacks. So that is the cashew nut. Cashew nut is an example for false fruit, and that also contains true fruit. It is a combination of false fruit and true fruit. True fruit is a dry fruit. Just above the true fruit, we can see false fruit. That is the modification of the pedicel. In Anacardium accidentale, the pedicel enlarges and forms fleshy part of the fruit. That is considered as the false fruit. And at the tip of the false fruit, say this is the false fruit, and at the tip of the first fruit you can see true fruit. This is true fruit and this is the false fruit, and it is formed from the swollen pedicel. After fertilization, the pedicel, what is pedicel? It is the stalk of the flower. The stalk of the flower enlarges and form the fleshy part of the fleshy edible part that is considered as the false fruit. So that is about the fruits. So far we have seen about the types of the fruit, mango fruit, botanical name of the mango fruit, origin and area of cultivation and uses of mango fruit. Then cashew nut, origin, botanical name, family name, origin and area of cultivation and uses of cashew nut. That's all about the fruits.